Now, we will discuss graphical this you all have studied in class 9 graphical approach to motion. In the graphical approach to motion, we have to consider variation of displacement, velocity, and acceleration with time. So we have to understand how the velocity, displacement, and acceleration varies with time. So first of all, we will start with displacement time graph. Displacement time graph. You will always consider time along x-axis. This is x-axis, this is y-axis, this is time t, and this is displacement in meter. This is in second. Now the first case, you walk from your class and move to the stairs and remain standing there, time goes on increasing. So at the stairs, you remains at rest. Displacement remains constant, but time goes on increasing. So what kind of motion is this? Displacement is constant means body remains at rest. This is constant. This is the first graph. First graph. Displacement time graph. Body remains at rest. Now you all know displacement and time. You all know displacement upon time is velocity. So from the graph of displacement time graph, from displacement time graph, we can find velocity by finding slope of the graph. Slope you all have read in mathematics in class 9th or 10th. Slope is y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1, that is equals to tan theta also, where theta is angle which line makes with positive x axis. So here in this particular case, you cannot find slope because this is parallel. Tan theta is 0. In this case, theta is 0 because line is parallel to x-axis. As theta is 0, tan theta is 0, which implies that slope is 0, which means velocity is 0. So body remains, body is at rest. So this is the first case where body remains at rest. Now the second displacement time graph, I will take it as uniform motion. Displacement time graph. This is x-axis, this is y-axis. Now in a uniform motion you cover equal displacement in equal interval of time. So the graph will move away from both x and y axis. This is the graph. This is uniform motion. Uniform motion means body is having constant velocity. Uniform motion means constant velocity. So in a graph like this, where graph is moving away from x and y axis, you can find slope, and this graph will give a constant slope throughout any point. I am considering one point here. So one point here means this is y2, and this point will be considered as y1, this is considered as x1, and this will be considered as x2. You can take it as theta also. So here slope will give velocity. Slope of what? Slope of OA line. Velocity will be y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. Y2 you will calculate from this side of y axis. Y1 will be the lowest value. Because I am explaining it again, in practicals board asks you to cover maximum part of the graph. So you will not make a small triangle. You will not do like this, taking these two points. Your result will be same, but this is not acceptable in boards. In boards, you have to consider more than 60% of the graph for finding slope. So I am taking one initial point and one last point. One more important thing, while drawing the graph or you find slope, you have to consider one point which is you have plotted in the graph and one point which is taken from the graph but you have not plotted that. That is, one point should be non-plotted, at least one point should be non-plotted. So when you draw a graph, various points will be there which are non-plotted. So you have to consider one point which is non-plotted and another point which is plotted. That I will explain while doing the graph part in practical exams. So how you will find slope? Slope is this. You can also find slope by finding tan theta. Slope of OA which will give velocity. So here in this case, because graph is a straight line, slope, that is velocity, will be constant. And therefore motion will be uniform. Now the third graph. Variable motion. In variable motion, velocity keeps on changing, unequal displacement in equal interval of time. You can draw like this, or you can do it like constant displacement when there is decreasing. So this is displacement time graph non-uniform motion, unequal displacement in equal interval of time. So here it is non-uniform motion. How will you find velocity? Because velocity is changing everywhere, this is variable motion. So you need to find instantaneous velocity, that is velocity at a particular time. So you choose a time at which velocity is required. Draw a dotted line against that time. This is T1. At this time velocity is required in this particular question. Then you have to draw a slope, that is a tangent passing from that point on the curve. You will get this point. Take two points, that is A, and I am taking this as B. This is y1, this is y2, this is x1, this is x2. Now this velocity which you will obtain from at t1 will be instantaneous velocity. It will not remain same throughout the motion. If you want to find velocity at this time, it will go at this at the tangent at this point. So velocity keeps on changing. Here in this case, you can find instantaneous velocity at time t1, which is equals to slope of AB. Tangent is, this is taken as t. Slope of at O. Slope of AB, that is tangent at O, is equals to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. So this will give instantaneous velocity in variable motion. This is also explaining variable motion. You are having displacement which remains constant at a particular time, for a particular time, and then displacement goes on decreasing. So this is also variable motion. So this is all about displacement time graph. This is body at rest, uniform motion where velocity will be constant, and variable motion. So what we have concluded from displacement time graph is that from displacement time graph, by finding slope of the graph, you can find velocity. So displacement time graph, velocity can be obtained by finding slope of the graph.